In this video, we will learn about 8 easiest vegetables that we can grow in containers.
Subscribe and press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update from Urban Gardening.
Chili peppers can be easily started off from seeds. Buy good seeds to get better results. Sprinkle seeds over the soil surface and cover with a fine layer of same soil mix. Transplant seedlings when they have at least 4 to 5 leaves or when seedlings are 4 to 5 inches tall. Make sure to take the seedlings out with the root ball intact to avoid transplant shock. Make a 2 to 3 inch deep hole in the soil mix. Gently place the root ball into the hole and fill around it with the soil mix. For a bumper crop, make sure you plant them in groups as this will help in better pollination. Chili plants need direct sunlight for healthy growth. Find a sunny spot in your garden that gets at least 5 to 7 hours of sunlight per day. Pinch out the tops of the plant after 8 to 10 days from the transplant to encourage lots of branches and fuller growth. You can even plant them in small pots. Pots with 6 to 8 inch diameter can easily accommodate one plant. Time to harvest will vary for different types of chilies, but you can easily tell when they are ready by their size and color. Chilies are one of the most wonderful plants to grow because they come in such a wide variety of colors, sizes, tastes, and spice levels. Homegrown chili peppers have excellent color, texture and flavor, including many shapes and color not easily available in shops. Plant seedlings when they are 5 to 6 inch long, remove bottom leaves and plant them as deep as possible. Make a 3 to 4 inch deep hole in the soil mix and gently place the plant in the middle and fill up the space around with the soil. Tomatoes must be planted deeply. Deep planting encourages healthy and a strong root system. At the time of planting, cover bottom 2/3 part of the plant with the soil mix. After transplanting, give the plants a thorough watering. As plants grow tall, provide some support. Use trellis and sticks to support the plants. Tie the stems loosely to the sticks with twine or strips of thread. Tomatoes are heavy feeders and need ample nutrients to produce well and long into the season. After every 15 days, add 2 to 3 handful of compost per plant. After transplanting, you will start to see the fruit appear within 35 to 45 days. Harvest tomatoes one by one once they turn red. Use garden scissor to snip them off their branches. Tomatoes come in about every color from white to purple, black to yellow. You can choose from a large variety of tomatoes. Garlic needs sandy soil for its healthy growth. For that, mix some river sand in the soil mix. Break apart the garlic bulb and choose largest cloves to plant because they will have the best chance of sprouting. So the flat bottom part in the soil mix by keeping the pointed part just above the soil surface. Keep at least 4 to 6 inch gap between two cloves for healthy bulb formation. Place the container somewhere that gets 5 to 7 hours of sun. After every 10 to 15 days, dig up the top layer of the soil to keep it soft and fluffy. This will help the bulbs to grow big in size. Water only when soil starts to dry up. Avoid wet and soggy conditions. Once top leafy part starts to turn brown and start to die off, at this stage garlic bulbs are ready to be harvested. Pull the bulbs out of the soil and hang them in a dry location to cure or dry. Peas are perfect vegetable to grow in container gardens. Soak seeds in water for at least 12 to 14 hours before sowing. This will help the seeds to germinate faster. Peas like rich, well-drained soil. For that, mix some manure or compost in the soil to get good results. In a 20 to 25 inch diameter pot, we can easily plant 5 to 6 pea plants. Sow seeds 4 to 6 inch apart for healthy growth. They grow quickly and don't need much attention. They do need full sunlight and soil needs to be kept evenly moist for constant growth. As plants grow, create a support structure with the help of bamboo poles or stakes. Peas are rarely bothered by insects or disease and are usually ready to eat about 3 weeks after they start to flower. From a single pea plant, we can easily get 20 to 25 pea pods. Harvest as soon as the peas are plump and ripe. When they go past their peak, they get starchy and lose their sweetness. Radishes are one of the fastest growing vegetables. Different varieties are available in the market to choose from. Sprinkle seeds at the final place as they don't do well with the transplants. Loose, well-drained sandy soil is ideal for root vegetables. Mix some river sand in the soil mix to get good size harvest. As they germinate, thin the seedlings to about 2 to 3 inches apart, allowing some space to develop unobstructed. Keep the soil evenly moist, watering frequently will result in quick growth. The greens of all radishes are also edible. Harvest them when their roots are about 1 to 1.5 inch in diameter. To harvest, gently pull the entire plant out of the ground with your hand. Cabbage and cauliflower belong to the same family. Start them with seeds. Prepare seedlings separately as their seeds are similar in appearance. Transplant seedlings when they are 4 to 5 inches tall or they have at least 4 to 5 leaves. In a 22 inch diameter pot, we can easily plant 3 to 4 plants. Keep 6 to 8 inch gap between 2 plants for healthy growth. Plant cabbage and cauliflower in full sun. They need 5 to 7 hours of direct sunlight for uninterrupted vigorous growth and head formation. You can also plant single plant in a 7 to 8 inch diameter pot. Water well after transplanting to avoid transplant shock. Add compost or manure in the soil as a side dressing after every 18 days for healthy and big size heads. Under good growing conditions, the heads develop rapidly to about 6 to 8 inches in diameter. Cut the whole head from the main stem. The mature head should be compact and firm. Purple cabbage tends to take 20 to 25 days more than the green variety. Choose varieties that have a shorter maturing time. To get good size harvest, mix soil, compost and river sand in equal proportions. Make sure you have a deep container that is at least 12 to 15 inches deep that allows the edible roots to grow well into the soil and keep the soil wet to maximize growth. After germination, thin carrot seedlings to about 2 to 3 inches apart. Feed carrots with manure or compost regularly. Repeat after every 20 days. Most of the carrot varieties are ready for harvest in 60 to 75 days, whereas you can harvest baby carrots much earlier. Harvest the carrots by pulling them straight out of the soil.